Welcome back to City Skylines, in the second episode of Commodore. And today we shall continue this magnificent little town which does not have a name. And basically I want to build the main boulevard, because although we do have this boulevard over here which is pretty neat, but I want to build a very wide and nice boulevard that's gonna work well with all the traffic, because basically the highway is over here, but there's gonna be people living everywhere on these islands, and there isn't really any highway to come here. Let's say if you live here, so you have to like pass through all of these roads. So we need like a good connection, because we want some roads that can support a lot of traffic. But before we do all of this, as you can see here, we need to put in some work zones. So let's go with some office buildings, and I have an idea to put all of the office buildings that are going to be in this city kind of like all in one area. Like that we can kind of have like the financial center. So maybe it could be like over here. This could be the financial center. I built this pretty large artery through town over here, which has one way going this way, one way another, and it's also going to have a bunch of these paths crossing it. And something pretty interesting that I want to share with you guys is, you see over here this cool little plaza we built in the first episode, how it's like nice little paved roads and not for like lots of traffic and whatnot, just for residents. Well, this road over here, I actually want to make it a long pedestrian road through this city. So it's going to cross here then, and we're going to put all the cobblestone and everything. But it's going to cross here, and then it's going to cross over here as well, and then it's going to continue. So that's going to be a pretty interesting concept. Let's see, maybe there's something in Rico that we have for offices. Yeah, a cool little office building or something that we can place. Oh, this is cool. Perfect. Yeah, it's kind of... Yeah, whatever. Let's place it here. It's... Honestly, it's perfect. And it like, gets rid of the monotony of all these same buildings and same, you know, like, little roofs and things, like the European style. All right, so I've placed them over here, and then I placed it on these little narrow streets over here as well. And look how cool this looks because it's so narrow. Like, this is a very interesting looking road. And don't worry, I won't like fill out all of my roads with cobble onto them. This is just because this is kind of like the little nice thing about this neighborhood, you know. Like, so there's gonna be some cobbled roads, you know. It's just kind of like what distinguishes this neighborhood maybe from the one on the other side, you know. And so now I guess we can put some over here as well. So this will be, this is I guess our first park, guys. It's not a big park, but it's a park because there's greenery and everything, and it's a bit bigger than, yeah, I guess it's a square, kind of. But yeah, so here there's these paths, which I guess we can just cobble them down as well. I guess these I'm gonna do them by hand. Yeah, you see how cool this cobble makes everything look? It's really worth it. Let's take out the gates. So I guess we can go with yeah, no, this wouldn't look too good. My classic one. This one. So I think, yeah, I guess, so I guess if this goes like this, perfect, then this one I can just place it by hand. Back to needing more people. So let's place all these homes over here. And yeah, because all these people are kind of living in this cool little area. This cool little area. It's kind of like an old town or something. So I'll think of a name for it. Let's call it Galia. Or Galia or something. Yeah, Galia is good. Did I spell it? Yeah, okay. So, well, basically, how I see it is kind of like a bunch of little districts. It's kind of gonna form a big town eventually, but it's just gonna be like a lot of districts. So this is the district of Gallia. Or maybe Dahlia is better. So basically, it's mostly just going to be a bunch of parking lots. But this is just like decoration right now. I mean, no cars are going to come here really. And then I'm just going to put. But before I put the cars, I'm just going to make all of this like this. Beautiful. And I guess I should do that for a little bit. No, not here. A few patches of greenery like this kind of, and then have the parking lots I was telling you about, just like this. And one like here. I guess here there's this. Let's like say that maybe this can open or something like that. Sound like the police cars can like if they leave here to go do their duty, but they can also like leave here and then like escape quicker, go where they have to go quicker before instead of going on the roundabout and everything. That's pretty cool. And let's put one of these here as well. Yeah, let's do this here too. Because like, yeah, Fresh Popcorn said this, like, that parking lots are super important, and it's true. Like, people tend to forget about parking lots, and I myself as well. Like, I really do. I admit this. Like, I don't really put parking lots normally. So, but yeah, it's a very good idea, and it's honestly pretty fun putting parking lots in. I like it a lot because it makes it look very realistic. So yeah, like why not put parking lots? And it's cool because, or else these places are pretty empty. Like, what are you gonna put here? Change the name again of this part of the city. It's called Alba. Yeah, it's a prettier name, honestly, guys. And look at this roundabout. I find this a very pretty roundabout. Honestly, it kind of inspired me for the name because it's white. But yeah. Also, I was thinking about a name maybe that goes well with the cobblestone roads. Like, but they're golden, so maybe something with gold. But I don't know. Alba is good. So honestly, so here they need a bunch of workers, and I'm guessing it's because they need education. Like everyone is kind of dumb right now. They need to learn to how to work on offices. So let's place our first school, and I'm thinking about for the school to kind of have like a nice big plot of land. Yeah, okay, maybe over here, and then this whole place can kind of be like the school's domain. Yeah, this whole nice place. So over here, let's say if I place homes or whatever, let's do this like this. And maybe we can put like a little entrance over here. Yeah, something like this. And this over here can be like all like the whole schoolyard kind of. All right. Why don't you want to place yourself? All right. So this can kind of be the schoolyard. Yeah, burn down. I don't want you to be here. I can't take it off when it's on fire. That's funny. Okay. So but yeah. All right. So here can be the back, the this thing. But in the same time, though, if I do this, maybe it's a better idea that I just close it off, because over here is like the main boulevard, so there's no need really to have it connected to the main boulevard. It would actually be like not a good idea. And yeah, might as well use these pretty chubby ones, and I'm gonna put them like this as to not cover the sidewalk. Yeah. And maybe like a few here as well. I'm gonna put other types of trees too. But these are very like big and bushy, so it's good to hide the nastier parts of the wall, the parts of that I wasn't able to make them look that nice. But okay, so let's see what schools we got. So we got an orphanage. Okay, this would be a cool place for an orphanage, honestly. And it fits in perfectly here, like, amazingly perfect. But no, I won't put that. I'll put a little school here. Alright. So this is looking pretty cool. And they got quite a lot of privacy. So let's take out a surface painter. Maybe we can put gravel or something. This is very dark. Yeah, no, I like the lush green. We can have it, but just like little blotches of it, like, you know, kind of like this is where the kids play. Yeah, so something like this. Then, yeah, so this road over here is like, really, people are gonna have to drive slow on it, cause I mean, they're entering. But it's mostly people, parents coming to pick up their children. I say we put this gravel path. The gravel looks pretty cool in this theme. It's pretty interesting, and we might as well do this too, so that they actually walk here, you know. So, let's see, maybe I can put a few more of these trees or something, kind of to hide the ugliness, but I don't want to hide the whole place here. So I guess we can put some of these little cutie pie trees. Nice, nice. They really are cute. I want to put some of this trees. Yeah, that's pretty cool. And put some here on the sides. All right, that's pretty cool. And some on the highway for sure, on the side of this road, just to have some privacy. But this over here, kids don't really come here to play. I mean, if they really want to, they can come. You know, it's not like closed. Actually, it is closed off, but they have to like kind of like crawl under this tree and then they come here. But this is mostly just like a nice barrier from the road so that they have a little bit of privacy. And also, I'm guessing for butterflies or something because all these flowers. Okay. And let's put one flower here too. Let's put one over here. Let's put one over here, one over here. All right, pretty nice. So now that we got this, let's put the park thing that attracts people. I hope it's gonna attract them. Let's put that over here as well. And let's put some playground things. So what do we have? We have swings for sure. So some nice swings over here because there's a big open field. Then they can play like in the sand over here. So here they have a big place. It's like a very big for them to run and whatnot. That's pretty cool. Over here, let's put a, where is that? Those doors that open. Yeah, this thing. I love this prop. This is, I use it so often. Like, it's really, really cool. And it's perfect for what I need. And it's default too. Like, think about how cool it is. And it's made for like industrial buildings, but you know, it works perfectly in this situation. That's magical. Those swings over there under the tree, that's very nice. I'll put some here as well. And some more of these. And we'll put this guy over here. And what is this? Another little park over here. So they really have a lot of things. This is a good school for kids. They have very high rates. They have very like a lot of people that are asking to join the school. You know, all the parents want to bring their kids here. And then they ha should have some tables too for the kids if they want to hang out, like older kids. And over here too, I guess. Yeah, they can kind of eat here, but not too much because here they're kind of close to the road and people can like bother them or something. Maybe you can put a table over here too, honestly, because if I'd be a parent and I'd come to pick my kid up or something, I'd probably want to sit down somewhere and just take it easy, kind of, you know? And like wait for him. I wouldn't want to stand up the whole time. I had something in mind, now I forgot. Oh yeah, parking spaces. That is a must. But now there's all these kids here, so that's kind of, they're kind of in the way. But if I do this, like this, that's not that bad. And maybe, yeah, so the kids don't really go. Where can I park these cars? I guess over here as well. So they're not, so there's not gonna be too many parking spots, you know. But the ones that there will be are like gonna be so crucial. Yeah, normally there's like very big parking lots, you know, where schools are. But I guess these are just for teachers, kind of, and when the parents come pick their kids up, they can just leave their cars like on the road over here. That's fine. No one will say anything about it. Let's see, where are the cars? All right, so we got these nice SUVs. We got that person over there, so I guess we won't park it over there. Here we'll park this guy to kind of hide the grass off. That's like the principal, the principal's car. Everybody fights for these spaces. Finally, a red car. Thank God. I was starting to get annoyed. I'm pretty annoyed with all these cars that I wanted a red one. Okay, so I guess we can park some of these cars kind of on the side, but then they're just gonna walk through them. Yeah, I guess like on this side works pretty well. Yeah, that's not that bad, honestly. And you know, it gets pretty like packed during after, like when they come to pick their kids up. So that explains why there's so many cars at the moment over here. You know, and they got their lights flashing and everything. So it's all right. There, no one's gonna hit them. Oh, that guy was gonna hit him. All right, so yeah, so this is pretty cool. Like I can imagine myself being a kid and just coming out, and I see like my mom waiting in this red car, and I'm like, "Hey, mama!" Maybe not everywhere, I guess. Maybe just like in some areas. Because over here, it's probably like they probably play soccer or something here, or they run. They have like those 50-meter sprint races. I don't know if you guys had that in elementary, but I did. And yeah, those 50-meter sprint races, probably like from here to here, but they probably for sure have this year. They're like, "Hey, let's go, let's do it, boys and girls." Let's put here some nice benches for everyone that just wants to relax a little bit. Like the boys and the girls that are getting tired and don't want to sit on the ground. Because honestly, this yard over here, like you gotta imagine that there's kids, some in kindergarten, they're like 5 years old, and some that are like in sixth grade, so they're 12, so you gotta accustom to all their needs, you know? Here's like a fun place. Here they think probably some kids like smoked their first cigarette or something behind this tree. Okay. And yeah, so it's pretty cool, but honestly it's kinda small considering like it's a school, like it's not a big place, and at they kind of took this whole like the city is like, "Okay, I'm gonna take a big part of your land and I'm just gonna dump this dog park here." But you know what? It's such is life, I guess. And honestly, probably like half the kids just standing here on the gate, just looking at the kid at the dogs when they're on break. And over here's a very nice path. This one's a pretty nice path. And over here is like the better kids that can stay here, the kids that they can trust, that they know they're not gonna run away. So yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you guys in the next episode. Let me know what you guys think of Alba, which now the population is 1,300, growing pretty quickly. And I like European because the buildings aren't too tall, so it makes sense. Like 1,300 people in a city this big kind of makes sense. Makes more sense than the American apartment buildings where there's like this much from apartment buildings would still be 1,300. And like it would look like it's 10,000, you know, it kind of looks like a pretty big city already. But that's why I like European. And honestly, I just see literally like a huge mass of this type of thing. But yeah, this is well, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you guys in the next episode.